Hello everyone, I'm Teacher Jen, and in this video, I will explain the difference between kinetic and potential energy. This morning, I ate egg sandwich, milk, and 2 pieces of tiny pancakes. How about you? What did you eat this morning? Alam niyo ba kung bakit mahalagang kumain tayo? Simply because we need energy so we can work, and we obtain the energy we need from the foods that we eat. Kaya ikaw, siguraduhin mong kumain ka bago ka magtrabaho, para hindi ka manghina at maliyo. Energy is defined as the ability to do work. When work is done on an object, it gains energy. But when work is done by an object, it loses energy. In this case, work is done by the small bottle on the big bottle. And so, the small bottle is the one who loses energy, and the big bottle is the one who gains energy. When work is done, it is accompanied by the transfer of energy. And this transfer of energy is considered kinetic energy. Kinetic comes from the Greek word kinetikos, which means moving. And so, kinetic energy is the energy of motion. The colliding bottles. The second hand of the clock. The electric fan. The moving door. The rolling tape. The moving car. The boy and girl dancing. At lahat ng bagay na gumagalaw, lahat sila, they have kinetic energy. The formula on how to calculate kinetic energy is, kinetic energy is equals to mass times velocity squared divided by 2. Or, kinetic energy is equals to 1/2 times mass times velocity squared. Let's try solving this. A 1,000 kilograms car has a velocity of 17 meters per second squared. What is the car's kinetic energy? Let's apply the GRESA. Again, G stands for given, R for required, E for equation, S for solution, and A for the answer. Given our mass, which is 1,000 kilograms, and velocity, which is 17 meters per second. Required is kinetic energy, and the equation to be applied is kinetic energy is equals to 1/2 times mass times velocity squared. The solution is kinetic energy is equals to 1/2 times 1,000 kilograms times 17 meters per second square. 1 divided by 2 is equals to 0.5. Then copy the mass, which is 1,000 kilograms, and multiply 17 meters per second by itself. 17 times 17 is equals to 289 meters per second. And the car's kinetic energy is 144,500 joules. Joules is the unit of energy. Based from the equation, we can say that the two factors that can affect kinetic energy are the mass and velocity. When an object's mass doubles, its kinetic energy also doubles. And the faster an object moves, the more kinetic energy it has. The other type of energy is called potential energy. It is the stored energy of an object due to its position or state. It is called elastic potential energy when the state of an object is compressed or stretched. Tulad ng mga rubber band and spring. And it is called gravitational potential energy when the object is raised or lifted from the ground. Lahat ng mga nakataas or nakangat sa lupa ay mayroong gravitational potential energy. The formula for gravitational potential energy is potential energy is equals to mass times gravity times height. When solving this, always remember that the acceleration due to gravity is always 9.8 meters per second square. Here's a sample problem. A ball with a mass of 0.5 kilograms is lifted onto the shelf, which is 1.5 meters above the ground. Calculate the gravitational potential energy of the ball. Again, apply the GRESA. Given R, mass, which is 0.5 kilograms, gravity, which is 9.8 meters per second square, and height, which is 1.5 meters. The required is potential energy or gravitational potential energy. The equation to be used is potential energy is equals to mass times gravity times height. The solution is potential energy is equals to 0.5 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second square times 1.5 meters. And the gravitational potential energy of a ball is 7.35 joules. Again, joules is the unit of energy, whether it is kinetic or potential energy. Again, kinetic energy is the energy of motion. You can calculate it using the formula kinetic energy is equals to 1/2 times mass times velocity squared. And potential energy is a stored energy due to its position or state. The equation to calculate it is gravitational potential energy is equals to mass times gravity times height. Now, look around you and try to find objects with kinetic and potential energy. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like my video and subscribe to my YouTube channel.